It is a brand new day. I got up, had something to eat, and I'm gonna go work out. But first, I wanna show you what I have been up to. So back in like February, March time, I took a fitness instructor specialist course and through CamFit Pro, and I passed the theory, and now I have to do my practical. So I was writing up my class just on my laptop here, and I'm doing my practical to 1 week today, actually. It's gonna be at 11 o'clock next week, and right now it's 11:29. Yeah, so that's what I was up to. And yeah, I'm gonna go and do a workout now. I'm a little bit anxious for it, not gonna lie, because I'm making the class a week before and I gotta memorize it and do it a few times. But I feel like everything's gonna come together because I have been teaching fitness classes since I was 18, so like 5-6 years now, so it will be totally fine. It's just, yeah, the lack of preparation on my end is what causes me some of that stress, but it's okay, it's gonna be totally fine. My goal is today to finish all of the choreography, and then tomorrow I can actually just practice the whole thing. So here's the fit for today's workout, all black. And basically what I'm gonna be doing is a group fitness class called Body Attack, which I grew up doing. I'm actually an instructor for it. And I try to do it once a week, but I haven't done it for 2 weeks. So I'm gonna go do that. And then it's also gonna give me inspiration for creating my group fitness class that I have to do next week. So yeah, let's go. So whenever I do like a workout where I run, jump around, hit like, group fitness workout, that kind of thing, I come to this gym at my school, and I got a ton of space to do so, and most of the time in the morning no one's here, so I get the whole place, which is really nice. Very difficult. So I thought I would provide a little bit of a better explanation with regards to my group fitness journey. So basically I started doing group fitness classes when I was 12. My mom brought me to Good Life, to the gym, and my main ones were Les Mills Body Attack, which is a sports inspired like cardio workout, and I did a few others as well throughout the week. And I kind of did that till the end of high school, until I was 18. It was a huge part of my life. I really got involved in that community with all the instructors and everything, and I was inspired to become an instructor for specifically Body Attack. So I did that when I was 18, and I actually had the opportunity to teach a class in my first year of university. But then that club closed, and then I also realized it was a little bit too much for me to go back and forth from university back home once a week to teach a class. So what I did was I became a spin instructor to teach classes at my university, because you could only teach Les Mills Body Attack at Good Life Fitness in particular, because they have like a license for it. So I did that, and then in my fourth year of university, the manager of the gym at McMaster, the Pulse, amazing lady and group fitness instructor, she was really inspiring, but anyways, she gave me the opportunity to take the official like fitness instructor specialist course, which is your typical group fitness instructor
course offered in Canada through CanFit Pro. So I took that, and that has multiple parts, including attending the actual training, which I did on Zoom because it was over the pandemic. And then you have to do a written theory exam, which I did, and I got like 96 or something on it, but we don't need to talk about that. And then, well, it's only because I did a kin degree. So like, I already know a lot of the fitness principles, stuff like that. And anatomy, physiology, all that. And then you have to do a practical. And since I sprained my ankle, I couldn't do that in the summer when I wanted to. So I am finally healed. I feel comfortable running and jumping around without thinking about, you know, taking care of my ankle. Like, it's totally automatic again now, which is great. And that is the point where I wanted to be before I did my FIS practical, and I'm here now. So I'm going to be doing it next week, and then once I get my FIS, I can teach group fitness basically anywhere, make my own group fitness classes, which I did before as well. But I guess I'll have the official certification, which is always a good thing to have in my back pocket, because why not? So yeah, that's basically my little journey with that. All right, I'm gonna get back home now. 12:30 right now. Got a bunch of stuff to do later today. First things first is grocery shopping though. I'm gonna walk to the grocery store because I'm pretty much out of food, and I have been for the past 2 days, so I've been eating the most random things. So let's get to it. Alright, so back from the store, I thought I'd do a little haul. So I got some turkey for sandwiches, as well as some Asian pears for my fruit of the week. Bought some egg whites, almond milk. I actually got the wrong one. I usually don't get vanilla, I usually just get the plain, but that's okay. I bought a little nail polish to do because I took off my fake nails and I still want them to be white. Of course, some chocolate. And now for the fun stuff. I got 2 packs of these holiday Christmas cookies that we're gonna make tonight. And my favorite, a gingerbread house that I'm gonna make tonight as well. So yeah, we're gonna do that tonight, which is super exciting. That's what I got. Right in the middle on the range, yeah. Day number 10. Yay. Benefits of getting a large pizza to yourself. Last night I got a large pizza. I just have like a bunch of leftovers for the entire weekend. So that's what lunch is gonna be and what dinner is gonna be tomorrow. So the gingerbread house and cookies were definitely a success. Sorry, just trying to fix my hair. gonna go for dinner now. We're gonna go for all you can eat sushi, which is gonna be so much fun. Haven't done that in a little bit. And yeah, I'm excited. I feel like this has been the most festive Vlogmas video yet. It was so much fun making those cookies and the gingerbread house. I don't know, it's actually kind of stressful to make a gingerbread house, but it was fun in the end. I feel like it was the best one I've made so far. Decorated pretty nice. Anyways, yeah, then went for sushi, which was nice. And I'm tired, it's 11. I'm used to going to sleep in undergrad. If you told me I'd be going to sleep before 12, I wouldn't have believed you. I firmly believe like there was no way I could go to sleep before 12. I had tried, I just couldn't. But in this degree, I literally go to bed at like 10:30, 11 every day because I'm so beat at the end of my days. And then on the weekends, I have the opportunity to stay up a little later if I want here and there. Most of the time I'm just tired, so when I do stay up late or like 12, 12:31, I am so tired by then. But yeah, that's okay. It's just because I have to get up every day earlier in this degree. Anyways, that was a little tangent. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you're enjoying Vlogmas in general. It's basically just like a series of videos of what is going on in Alina's life in December. Of a lot of the same stuff, because a lot of my days are pretty similar in school. But I don't know, I find it so much fun making these videos, and I hope you enjoy them as well. I think this was Vlogmas day 4 or 5. Day 5? 4 and 5? 4 or 5? We'll see. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you soon for Vlogmas day number 6.